A European psychiatrist wants to conduct a study to prove the power of magic mushrooms extends beyond the obvious of making you trip. He believes they also have the power to treat depression. Magic mushrooms, also known as shrooms, have been thought for centuries to contain healing properties, and in the 1950s, they were used as a psychotherapy treatment. The psychiatrist pushing for the research is Dr. David Nutt. He is known in the UK for his support to legalize illegal drugs, claiming alcohol is far more dangerous than other outlawed drugs, which he was later fired from his government job for saying. There is a chemical in shrooms called psilocybin that is believed to stop patients from dwelling on themselves and their inadequacies, which is often the reason for depression. Nutt, with his research financially backed by the British Neuroscience Association, plans to extract the psilocybin from shrooms and give it to 30 test subjects, equivalent to about 5 mushrooms. He would then test the neurological effects and compare it with 30 other subjects who were given a placebo. He would then repeat the test in 6 months. But not so fast. Nutt has quite a few hoops to jump through if he wants to start the research, because that magical ingredient in shrooms is what makes them illegal in the UK. Shrooms are a Class A drug, defined by the UK government as the most harmful, which makes getting a hold of the drug very difficult, and the special license needed to manufacture it can cost upwards of $153,000. Nutt told The Guardian, "The whole field is so bedeviled by primitive, old-fashioned attitudes. Even if you have a good idea, you may never get it into the clinic, it seems." A UK government spokesperson told the BBC, "The regulations are in place to keep citizens safe. Our licensing regime enables legitimate research to take place while ensuring that harmful drugs don't get into the hands of criminals," while Dr. Nutt makes this argument.
"By reducing the harms which are caused by criminalizing drug users. Criminality itself creates much, much more harms than the drug, so let's get it in proportion."
According to Dr. David Nutt, depression is the most common disorder in Europe, with only about a third of patients responding to current treatments. For Newsy, I'm Jasmine Bailey.